स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द रिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर फर्स्ट ऑफ ज्योग्राफी। वी विल स्टार्ट विद द समरी ऑफ द चैप्टर, देन अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट आई विल गिव यू अ वर्कशीट एंड यू हैव टू कंप्लीट दैट वर्कशीट। इफ एनी प्रॉब्लम, एनी क्वेरी विल बी देयर, प्लीज ड्रॉप अ मैसेज ऑन माई व्हाट्सएप नंबर एंड आई विल कॉल यू। Okay, coming to the chapter, the Earth in the solar system. As you see in the night sky, the sky is filled with tiny shiny objects. Some are brighter, others are dim. They seem to be twinkling. They twinkle because they are very far. Once in a month, we see full moon night, means Purnima, of a fortnight later, means fortnight means after a 2 week. You cannot see it all. It is a new moon night or Amavasya. The sun, moon, stars and planets and all those objects shining in the night are called celestial body. As I have told you, some celestial bodies, some emit lights and some do not emit lights. Those who emit lights are stars and those who do not emit lights are planets. Some celestial bodies are very big and hot. They are made of gas, have their own heat and light. They emit in large amounts. These celestial bodies are called stars. Our sun is also a star and 8 planets revolve around it. While watching the night sky, we notice various patterns formed by different group of stars. Have you noticed? The common one is Saptarishi. You can see that in the night, a structure, a pattern of spoon. You can very easily see it. These are called, these groups are called constellation. Ursa Major is one such constellation. I have explained you that Ursa Major forms a shape like a bear. So it is also known as a big bear. In ancient time, people used to determine directions during the night with the help of the stars, and the north star indicates the north direction. It is also called the pole star. Some celestial bodies do not have their own heat and light. I have told you that planets do not have their own heat and light. They are lit by the light of the stars. Such bodies are called planets. Coming to the solar system, the sun, 8 planets, satellites and some other celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteoroids forms the solar system. You can see, earlier also I have explained you, the sun, 8 planets, asteroids and meteoroids forms a solar system. The sun, you can see, the sun is in the center of the solar system. It is huge and made up of extremely hot gases. The sun is the ultimate source of heat and light for the solar system. Coming to planets. The word planets come from the Greek word planetai, which means wanderers. They are called wanderers because they revolve around the sun. You can see how many planets are there. There are 8 planets: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. There are 8 planets. All the 8 planets of the solar system move around the sun in a
fixed bar. Beta, they do not move here and there. They used to move in a fixed path. These paths are elongated. They are called orbit. Beta, till August 2006, Pluto was also there. There were 9 planets. Pluto was also a planet, but now it is called only a celestial body. And it is a dwarf planet. Okay, now coming to the planet Earth. The Earth is the third nearest planet to the Sun and is our home. It is slightly flattened at the pole and bulged from in the middle. That is why its shape is called a geoid. Conditions favorable to support life are probably found only on the Earth. From the outer space, when we see from the outer space, the Earth appears blue because its two-thirds surface is covered by water. It is therefore called a blue planet. Now coming to Moon. Our Earth has only one natural satellite, that is the Moon. It appears so big because it is very near to our planet than other celestial bodies. The Moon moves around the Earth in about 27 days and 8 hours. The Moon does not have conditions favorable for life. Asteroids. There are numerous tiny object bodies which move around the Sun. These bodies are called asteroids and they are found between the orbit of Mars and Jupiter. Meteoroids. These small pieces of rocks which move around the Sun are called meteoroids. Second, a galaxy. You know that a galaxy is a huge system of billions of stars and cloud of dust and gases. These billions of such galaxy that makes the universe. Thank you, Beta. This was a short summary of a chapter. Videos are available in the YouTube. You can see them again. And if any problem is there, as I have said, please contact me. Thank you. Do the worksheet. Thank you, Beta.